My name is ASMR Kitten, and we're gonna relax today with a little let's play. So, I'm really excited for this game. It's called Coffee Talk. So, I was a barista for not one, not two, not three, not four, but 5 years. So, in this game, onto the Nintendo eShop the other day, I was really intrigued, and I've been seeing a lot of streamers and Let's Players talk about it, so I figured you and I could enjoy some nice, cozy Let's Plays. So we're gonna erase this file. This wasn't a real file I made. What's your name? Everyone called me Cat because it's short for Caitlin, and if you're really busy, it's so much easier to yell the name Cat at somebody than it is the name Caitlin. So we're gonna start with the story, a game by Duke Productions, Seattle 2020. A city filled with dreams and madness. A time when the great war between races is but a footnote in history. A time when anyone can dream of being whatever they want to be, and have those dreams crushed before they can even be discussed. Ouch. But still, it is a place and a time where anything can happen. It is when the elves have left the forest to build their startups, when the dwarves have emerged from their caves to start their automotive empires, when the orcs have put down their axes and started using computers to improve their lives. And when humans live among them, as driven as ever, it is a city that holds many dreams and stories of its people. Most of these stories are left untold, but some find solace in the embrace of bricks and wood and glass. They are told over drinks, then take up residence in some stranger's memories. In one corner of the city stands a coffee shop, a place that is only open when the sun is sleeping, a place where people share their stories. And these are Tuesday, September 22nd, 2020. I'm just gonna turn the audio up on my end. Oh, welcome. Oh, it's you. Hey Cat, how's the night so far? It's calm. Supplier made some logistical errors. I don't have half my ingredients today. Man, that's a bummer. Don't worry, I can still serve the caffeine you desperately need. That's good to hear. Anyways, let me set things up first. You're our first customer, after all. Don't worry, take your time. I'm a writer, not an editor. Used to taking things slow. Writer's block again. You got that right. What are you writing now? Do Pardon the interruption.
The machine is ready. Do you want your triple espresso now? Yes, please.
And if you forget how to make it, just check your phone, okay? Anyways, I really need that triple espresso.
So, I did play the demo of this, and this is the demo, so I know how to make some drinks. Cup of triple espresso, special for my only customer tonight. That aroma. Ah, exactly what I need. Anyway, where were we? You're planning to do something.
Yes, that. It's not that I hate writing stories for the newspaper, you know, but it seems like the right time for something bigger.
So, a novel.
It sounded so simple when I was making the plan. At least you still have your job.
In case things go awry.
Did I say something wrong?
No, you were right. You said something I should have thought about myself.
What are you talking about?
You know who owns the Evening Whisper?
GRA Media.
Right?
Yes.
And they are also the biggest book company publisher in the country. So when the opportunity presented itself, I took it.
What do you mean by opportunity?
Well, I bumped into one of the big guys in the elevator. So naturally, I pitched my book idea.
Don't look at me like that.
Are you for real?
Yeah, it was such a stupid thing to do.
So how did they react?
Thankfully,
he'd seen my short stories. So he challenged me. If I could get a draft ready in a month, he'll pull some strings and get the fiction publishing division to sign me for a publishing deal.
Good evening.
For here, miss.
Yes, please.
I'm not really sure what to order, though. What do you recommend?
That highly depends on your mood. I'm here to meet my boyfriend. Not planning to be awake all night. So definitely no coffee.
How about something chocolatey? It's perfect.
Welcome.
So you're waiting for your boyfriend?
Yes.
He should be here soon.
Look at you now. You went from empty to 3 customers in one night.
I thought this place would be more crowded, considering it's the only coffee shop that's open after midnight around here.
Because it's the only coffee shop that's open past midnight, it's mostly empty.
Now that you mention it, is it good for business having a coffee shop only open at night?
Definitely not.
Yep, what she said.
Then why?
I just love doing it. And there's something. There's always someone longing for a warm drink at this hour. That's fascinating.
Are you a regular here?
I don't really have anywhere else to go.
I'm a writer who works best at night in a coffee shop. Not many options for that.
Ah, no wonder. She's a pretty good writer, you know.
You can find some of her short stories in the Evening Whisper.
Whispers?
Shut up.
Wow, that's really interesting.
What kind of things do you cover? Personal, interesting, weird stories. I also contribute to their short stories. I love their fiction.
You wrote those stories?
Thank you.
I wrote most of them, but not all.
That's so cool.
I picture her with like a valley girl accent.
Then are you here to write a new piece?
I should.
Something better to keep me awake with milk. Oh, and draw some latte art on top.
So, I think I'm gonna check the recipe, but I think it's espresso is coffee, coffee, milk.
Oh, that would be a cappuccino. Okay, let's check the bitterness of that.
I think that's good.
Ooh, the latte art looks good too.
Oh my god, wait, I have to do it.
Uh-oh, I pressed the button too quickly, I didn't get to the latte art.
Is that what you got, latte art?
That's cute.
Okay.
Sir.
Perfect. Anyways, I was distracted by some work, plus the rain.
It's okay.
I haven't properly introduced myself.
I'm Bailey's.
My, oh my, where are my manners? sacrifice my current projects for a minute of laughter. That might be worth it. You should ask Annie here how to deal with annoying clients. Oh yeah, how do you usually deal with annoying customers? Well, when I was a barista at Starbucks... This is like a Starbucks secret that I'm not supposed to share, but if someone was like really, 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 really awful to me, I would give them decaf coffee. Now, I would never, ever, ever give someone caffeinated coffee if they ordered decaffeinated coffee, because that's not okay. But when Karen comes in on her high horse in her white Lexus and is like, I need a venti non-fat, make it a triple, a latte with no foam, you need to check yourself at the door, Karen. So you just give them decaf and then they don't get that extra pick-me-up. So that's how I personally dealt with them. But back to the game. The ones you don't need your fists to take care of. I do have my own methods, but it wouldn't be wise to talk to customers about other customers. Now that's a good lesson for the day. Your parents. Yes. So you've talked to them.
I did.
It didn't end well.
No.
What did they say?
A lot.
They won't give us a chance at all.
Anyone but an elf.
That's what they said.
How about you?
More or less the same. Doesn't have to be. You know our families will never agree.
We can just continue like this.
What do you mean?
They don't need to know that we're still dating.
We can just continue the way we always have been, without them knowing.
And then what?
Do you want to be hiding our relationship for the rest of eternity?
We're not like humans, you know.
Just elope.
And you won't get permission because you're quote-unquote too old.
Lua, I don't care about their permission.
I'll be glad to sever my family ties if I have to.
I can't let you do that.
You'll lose your immortality.
If I get to spend my life with you, I won't mind.
I don't mind a bit.
You're making this hard on both of us.
So.
So, pour the milk is forward. Oh my gosh. I love this coffee shop, but I'm sure that's probably not the answer you're looking for. I didn't really have any expectations. Man, out of all the people in the world, why did I fall for her? You can't choose who you fall in love with. You can if you try hard enough. At least that's what my old man said. He really is one pretentious elf, but I guess all of them are. Titled pretentious immoral d-bags. At least you don't have an eternity to learn and change. At least you have an eternity to learn and change. Or an eternity to be an eternal butt hole. Anyways, I need to go and probably drink myself under until the sun rises. There's still a while until sunrise. More time for me to drink. I hope they find a way to be together. Me too. Anyways, I need to leave. I have to be up earlier than usual. Okay. I think I'm gonna close up after this. It's pretty early. I know. After the rest of delivery comes in, I'll open up as usual. Okay, you have a good night then. Me too. Sugar and spice, spicy, sweet, and natural bliss in a cup. So, I'm going to be right back. I'm gonna grab some water. I'm super thirsty from this gameplay. I'm back. Just super thirsty from all that dialogue. Wednesday, September 23rd. Evening whispers, zombie virus from Africa may have reached Seattle. Seattle groceries, distribution problems, harm local restaurants. FIRE plans to enforce stricter regulations to manage illegal immigration. Fire instead of ice. That's funny. What's wrong with you? Can't you just enter like a normal customer? I'm sorry, but I'm so excited to share this with you. What are you talking about? I know what I'm gonna write for my novel. Is it one of your impulsive temporary ideas again? Hey, don't be rude, I'm being serious here. Okay, just tell me, what are you gonna write about? This coffee shop. Say you can't do that.
I'm really excited to see what's gonna come tonight. I wonder what kind of stories they'll have. Good evening, y'all. Good evening, Officer Georgie. Hey, Pop. Seems like you're in high spirits this evening, Miss Freya. And please, Kat, no need to be that formal with me. We're both on duty. The formalities. You're as stiff as ever. Anyways, I have a shift tonight, so I'll need the usual. You have all the ingredients today. Not everything, but more than yesterday. Except for tea. I'm out of tea. You still remember my favorite, right? Coffee with a hint of sweet. Read that. I was trying to figure out what it said. Sweet, healthy coffee, please. Okay. Oh, so this has like your friends lists. That's cool. So let's look at what he would like. So I'm guessing I'd make him coffee. This honey, and what's this? Ginger? No, don't get rid of that. Not ginger. So I'm guessing coffee, honey. That's really sweet. Maybe it's just coffee, honey. I used to have a guy come in and get coffee with two honeys every morning. Coffee with honey. Not everyone can manage this combination as well as you. Thank you. By the way, I haven't ordered anything myself. Find me the service like you gave old Pop here, please. What are you having? You need to ask, huh? You never know. Espresso, of course. The one and only espresso. Starless night for the green-haired fairy. I'm not even sure if that's a compliment or not. This is perfect. So how's everything going at the paper, Miss Freya? As usual. Awful. She's making a risky deal with her boss. Yeah, pretty much. What kind of deal?
Good. What will it be about? A coffee shop and the stories the people tell inside. You're letting her do that. There's no stopping her. It's fine. Please don't write about any shady looking police officers who love to take more breaks than they should inside a coffee shop. I'm definitely writing about that police officer. He'll experiment. Oh, welcome, Mr. Gala. Hey, cat. Can we sit here? Sure thing, sir. You can speak. Sorry to interrupt. Do you want to order anything? Yes. What do you want to drink? You first. Okay. Anything with coffee and ginger, please. Okay, so can I not go to the top? It's not letting me scroll on the thing, so I guess we're gonna do coffee, ginger, and milk. They didn't say anything about no milk, so. Your order is ready, sir. Happy the bar goes down with a smile. What's the smile if you don't mind? Nothing. I was just wondering. Will history repeat itself? Wow. This guy's a jerk. Certainly.
What's going on? Where did this conversation go?